Wingapa, it's me, Chadu.
I woke up like this. I woke up like this.
People, actually, my hair is just down. Actually, it was in like a messy bun when I went to sleep. And then, people, tell me if you're like this. Okay. There's like so much glare in my glasses. People, tell me if you're like this. Like, if your hair stays in one like style too long, your scalp hurts. Like, it doesn't matter if it, the worst is like a tight ponytail or tight like ballet bun. Like, you don't have to tell me that's like honestly the worst. But like, if your hair is parted to a certain way for too long, like this, your scalp around your part starts to hurt. Or if it's like even in a messy bun that's not tied really tight, you know, then like the hair on the top starts to hurt. Are you like that? I'm like that. So I always like am changing my hairstyles, honestly, people. Like, in one day, I probably like go through like 5 different hairstyles just because my scalp starts to hurt. Anyway, so I had to take it out, and then it was down, right, for a little while, and then my scalp started to hurt, so then I did this. This is what I do sometimes. I just grab my hair loosely, and I put it on top of my head with no rubber band, and I just put my hood like this. So then this is how it's, like, comfortable for my scalp. Is that weird? I mean, it looks weird, but that's my logic behind it. P.S. If you don't follow me on Snapchat, this is the first time you're seeing my new glasses. These are my new glasses. Remember, like, maybe like 2 weeks ago, I went to the optometrist. Yeah, these are my new glasses. And it's so crazy how clear I can see. Like, I didn't realize, because my other glasses I had for like 2 or 3 years. And I didn't realize that my vision was like blurry, like kind of more fuzzy. But once I put these ones on, I was like, whoa, I can see like the crisp lines of objects. It's so weird. So then I did like, on my Snapchat, I did I tried on my old glasses and I tried on these ones. I was like, oh my God, so different. But anyways, yeah, these are them. They have like tortoise shell kind of. And they have these gold arms with a little bit of a tortoise shell. But yeah, look it, and they're all smudged already, and I just got them yesterday. Ugh, a pimple in my scalp. Ow, and I know my eyes look disgusting, because you know how like when you wash your face or when you take off your makeup, sometimes like a little bit of like mascara residue or eyeliner residue to like takes more time to take off. But honestly, people, when I take off my makeup at night, I'm so like the end of the day, I'm just so tired. I'm just like coconut oil, rose toner, clean it, little bit of moisturizer. I don't even care, honestly. I don't even care. Obviously, anyways, yeah, I just wanted to show you guys my new glasses. Oh yeah, they are Gucci. They are Gucci glasses. Anyways, it's hot now. I need to turn off my heater. That's basically it. And I'm drinking just a tiny little bit of coffee. People, my voice is getting so much better. Can you hear it? Yes! I'm winning! My stomach acid is losing, finally. People, you guys know the war I've had with my stomach acid. But honestly, people, most of the reason was why? Because, you know, I went to the doctor, I think it was last week. Yeah, it was last week, I think. Yeah, it was. And she told me part of the reason that, you know, I was having that problem with my stomach acid coming up to my throat was because I ate so late at night because people, I get home like late, you know, just because the hours that I teach, like I usually get home around like 9, and sometimes I don't even eat dinner until like 10, so, or finish eating dinner until maybe past 10, so, and usually I'm like super tired, so I just like eat and just lay in my bed right away. But yeah, she said that the thing was that it doesn't matter what kind of food I would eat before I would lay down. It's the fact that, you know, my stomach is digesting food while I'm laying down, then the stomach acid comes up. So that's the main thing. Like, I've been trying to cut out, you know, all the acidic foods that I love. Coffee. People, I think I didn't have coffee once last week. On Saturday I did when I went to Disneyland, but I didn't have coffee for a whole week. It was honestly so bad because you guys know coffee is like a staple in my life. It's as essential to me as water, and you know how essential water is to me. I mean, to all humans, but especially me. But let me just tell you. So, but now, because before I used to make in my coffee thingy, I used to make, fill it up to the number 3 line, which I feel like it means 3 cups of coffee, right? 3 cups. So that would be my morning, every morning. And even like that was even a step down from how much I was drinking before, because before I was having like maybe like my, you know, 3 cups in the morning. And then I would maybe have like, maybe like 1 to 3 more cups in the afternoon, you feel me? So that whole week was really bad. Thankfully though, my sleeping has gotten better. Maybe there's some correlation. Less coffee equals more sleep. Who knew? Also, I think those melatonin vitamins are helping a lot too. Just saying. Anyways, so I've been like filling up my coffee maker to the number 2 line. So, and I've only had coffee today, and I had coffee yesterday. Oh, that was Monday. But anyways, it's because like, people, you know, I could have such good sleep. I could have 8 hours of beautiful sleep, uninterrupted. But, and I could, you know, go to bed at a reasonable hour, wake up at a reasonable hour, but still, like, it takes forever for me to like get started, you know? Like, I'm just like laying in my bed, looking at my phone. Like, I don't want to do anything. Like, I don't have like that spark in me to get started, right? So that's what coffee is for me. Because otherwise, I don't have that spark in me until I'm like literally teaching. And, you know, sometimes I have stuff to get done at home before I have to go teach, so, because when I have to go teach, it's like, I have no option. I have to have that spark in me, otherwise, the kids will not learn anything, so, that's basically it. Yeah, that's basically it. And people, my hair has gotten so long, and people are commenting, and it's so amazing. Isn't it so amazing? Because I really wanted to get extensions for like a while when my hair was taking forever to grow, because I hated my like little short blonde hair, because like everyone knows that bleach is damaging to your hair. So then when I had my, because honestly my hair was just growing out because my hair was super short, right? So it was just growing out. So the fact that I had bleached short hair made it seem that like, oh, she doesn't know how to take care of her hair because her hair is so short. She always has to cut it. It never grows. That wasn't even the thing. It was because I had such a short haircut to start with that it was taking forever to grow. And now it's like super long and everyone's like, oh my God, your hair is so long. I'm like, yes, yes, yes. It's amazing because now I don't have to pay like $1,000 for my extensions. Now it's just like all real, all natural. All natural, just add bleach. But yes. No, the only natural part is this little gross part. Anyways, I'm just so happy that it's growing. My goal is for it to cover my boobies, because that's how long my hair always was when I had my dark hair, my natural hair. Like, my hairstyle most of the time that I, you know, was long. It was just long. So I really liked having long hair past my boobies. This is what I'm hoping with my blonde hair I can have. But anyways, yes. That's it. Later, haters.